Hello, my name is Panagiotis Kribounis and I'm a PhD student at the AC department of NYU, where I work with Professor Sadi Prangan at NYU Wireless. And today I'm going to present to you an open source advanced wireless platform that can be used for beam tracking experiments in millimeter wave frequencies. Cosmos is an open access city scale advanced wireless testbed that is currently being deployed in New York City and is part of the NSF Platforms for Advanced Wireless Research Program. One of the key technological components of Cosmos is the variety of millimeter wave software-defined radios at 28 and 60 gigahertz. And more specifically, in this demo, we are going to illustrate some of the capabilities of the testbed by developing some open source code that will enable us to collect measurements for beam tracking. And we are also going to showcase some of the other experiments that you can run on Cosmos Sandbox One using these front ends and these baseband solutions. And all of the experiments will be with completely remote control. In this demo, we will basically utilize one of the indoor deployments of Cosmos that is basically used to develop some new algorithms and test new systems before you actually test them in the outdoor deployment. And in this deployment, you have a variety of millimeter wave front ends, such as the IBM 28 GHz phased antenna array board and the Siever 60 GHz transceiver. In the corner, we have like a server rack with baseband solutions, and one of the key features is that we can, using some RF switches, we can basically interconnect multiple baseband solutions and multiple RF front ends. In this tutorial, we will mostly configure the RF switches to have a communication between the Xilinx RF SoCs and the Siever's RF front ends. The Siever's arrays are mounted on top of XY tables. The XY tables are placed approximately 20 meters apart. The tables enable us to move on the X and Y axis, and they also enable some rotation around the Z axis. The XY tables can be controlled completely through a web interface, and they also provide some static images and live cameras. The live camera streaming, you can simply open it like with Python, you can even send some commands, and you can even see how the array moves and rotates in real time. One of the first applications that we build is the calibration, which is very important for any application. First, they utilize the automated IQ calibration from Siever's that is basically utilizing some internal loopback of the array, and this can be further improved using the methods developed by Aditya. And as you can see, just by fixing the RF, the receiver phase noise error, we are able to get more than 11 dB in the performance improvement. Another example that we have is the channel sounding sequence, and we basically send a continuous wave signal, and we do this kind of frequency domain channel sounder, and with in the receiver we do the correlation and we estimate the channel. On the right, you can see for a specific configuration what was the channel impulse response. And here you can see the demo, how you can run the script. Taking basically in one of the servers, we will start our custom web server that is controlling the Siever's arrays, and on the other end, we will start our channel sounding script that will configure the arrays, configure the FPGA boards. Then here you see the IQ calibration of Siever that is running every time. And then we send the sequence and receive the sequence at the end, does this kind of correlation and plots the PDP. And now utilizing the XY tables and the channel sounder, we are able to characterize the array response. And on the right, you can see this configuration, this response for a specific beam steering vector, where we take one of the arrays and we mechanically rotate it from minus 45 to 45 degrees. And The channel sounder and the XY table can also be used to create some motion. And the idea is that, like we do in 5GNR, one of the nodes might be in a motion and the other node might do some kind of like beam search. And the idea is that how can you basically track this information? And for this, we build this kind of like heat map, which is basically the normalized received power for each TX beam index at each time. And you can see the pattern of the array moving from minus 45, moving like from 0 to minus 45 degrees, again to 0, then to 45 degrees, and then back goes to 0. And someone can use the testbed and this kind of measurements to use and create some very good algorithms or use machine learning for beam. Finally, let's conclude this presentation. We presented some new millimeter wave experimental platform that is completely open source and programmable, and is comprised of advanced array front ends and baseband solutions, and enables experimentation in all layers of all networking layers. We showcase some of the demos and the experiments and the data that you can collect using these platforms. And some possible extensions to this work is to use machine learning for beam tracking, characterize the phase noise for the arrays, and you're always more than welcome to use our code, use the tutorials, and write your own experiments. If you want to learn more about our tutorials, you can visit this link. And if you want to have access to the open source code, feel free to check our GitHub page. Thank you. First, I would like to thank the NYU industrial affiliates, the NSF and the SRC for their support for this work. And I would also like to thank you for your attention. If you have any questions or if you need any help using the millimeter wave front ends at the Cosmos Sandbox one, feel free to reach out to me.